Sundays of competition left in the NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series 2022 season. Just 8 rounds remain. 8 rolls of the dice to finally answer the question, who are the best professional drag racers in the world? Today, in this city based around games of skill, games of chance, and games of financial courage, we have to ask ourselves one simple question. What are the odds? It would seem the odds are pretty good that a 5-time Pro Stock motorcycle champion will fend off all comers again. This would elevate his career legacy onto a platform that only 2 other competitors have ever achieved. Matt Smith has played the odds all year, and it does look like his gamble is set to pay off. He carries a very comfortable lead into the second-to-last race of the season. The salty and grizzled Vegas lifers will tell you that there's no such thing as a lock in this city of lights, but they've never met Erica Enders. At the start of the season, she vowed to be relentless, to give no quarter, and she has lived up to every one of those words. Today, she has a great chance to lock up a 5th championship, and she's better than even money to do it in her car, which has been more battering ram than Camaro all season long. On this penultimate elimination day of 2022, the funny car crown is very much up for grabs. 3 men sit at a nitro-powered poker table. Every one of them believes they're holding the winning hand. That being said, this is no game of chance. The player who once held a commanding chip stack has seen it dwindle, while the other 2 players have seen their stacks grow. The odds that someone's bluff is called today are absolutely astronomical. And finally, Top Fuel. The race for the title has been a macro study in how different people approach beating the house in Las Vegas different ways. Some come in and make huge bets, their fortunes skyrocketing and plummeting on the whims of dealers, machines, and bouncing balls. Contrasting that, there are many who arrive to play the penny slots, slowly, sometimes painfully adding to their coffers of success. And lastly, there are those prepared to let it ride, come what may. All 3 of these strategies collide on the drag strip today. It's time to place the bets. It's time to take the chance. It's time to beat the house or leave this place as so many do. Lighter in the wallet and sore in the head. The NHRA makes 2 stops a year at the strip at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, a sprawling, beautiful, and modern drag racing facility just 15 miles north of the great city of Las Vegas. The second stop in 2022 is home to the NHRA Nevada Nationals, and it turned out to be one of the craziest, most entertaining, and wildest races of the year. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Loans, and welcome to this NHRA in 30 Top 5 from Vegas. Matt Hagan's first round opponent was Stephen Densham, son of funny car racing legend Gary Densham. There was a wide performance gulf between the 2 cars on the qualifying sheet, but that gulf narrowed to blood-chilling closeness at the finish line stripe for Matt Hagan. You won't believe the way this one turned out. He's got cylinders out. Steve Densham cannot catch him. 4-12-3 beats a 4-12-1, a hole shot. Justin Ashley came into the Nevada Nationals on the back of an incredible race win in Dallas, Texas, where he dominated not only the starting line, his team dominated the performance ranks as well, never leaving the 3.6-second zone in his Top Fuel dragster. And then the first round came in Las Vegas. Ashley, a 38 light. Clay Milliken's hanging in there, and it's Clay Milliken. 369.5 at 330. It has happened again, Tony. Each of these countdown races has showed us some sort of incredible first round upset, and that just happened.
Yes, the door just swung open big time, not just for Brittany Force, but for Antron Brown, who is still in competition, and everyone else that just saw this race go down. This was the danger of drawing Clay Milliken. The 14th qualifying position was very misleading. They did not get down the track any of their qualifying runs. They were very fortunate there wasn't a full field, and there was a 69 in this car. That was the concern that anyone would have racing this car. He can get off the starting line. He gave up a couple hundredths of a second, but fortunately the team gave him the car to put it into the next round. And for Justin Ashley, his car, like a couple of other cars, have just fallen off when they should be running quicker.
The Funny Car Championship race has come down to 3 big names: Matt Hagan, Robert Hight, and Ron Capps. Ron Capps qualified well and was running well early in eliminations. And then he came up against Bob Tasca III, and an instant classic was born.
Whoa, boy. At the finish line, it's Bob Tasca the third. A huge moment here in the Funny Car Points Chase. 391.4, 329 miles an hour as Caps runs 393.8 at 329. That has titanic consequences.
Yeah, if you look at the reaction times, it appeared to be close on the starting line, but it really wasn't. Ron Caps used some of the real estate. Essentially, he shortened the track up. It was on the throttle first from the Motorcraft car. You can both see both of them roll in. Ron Capps, he's a little bit of an artist. He rolled in deep on the top light. He rolled in even more. But this is all about horsepower. It was all Bob Tasca. It was all Ford. It was all Motorcraft on the racetrack.
We watch Ron Capps make a final pull of the day here in this GR Napa Supra. And this is what it looks like at 329 miles an hour, a margin of 21 thousandths of a second. Back here at the Strip at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, Brian Lowe's Tony Pedregon in the booth, and this is the Sealmaster Track Walk, which was very well attended this morning by a sizable crowd of NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series fans, and all these folks got up early, at least early for Las Vegas time, and came out, enjoyed a beautiful morning, and took a cruise in their Barker loungers. We'll be back right after this. The NHRA Nevada Nationals is sponsored by Camping World, making RVing fun and easy since 1966, and by Dodge, domestic, not domesticated. Tony Stewart made his NHRA drag racing debut in an A-Fuel dragster competing in the top alcohol dragster category, tuned by the McPhillips family. Everybody was curious to see how the man who was in six racing halls of fames, including that of NASCAR and sprint car racing, would fare in a long wheelbase dragster. It got very interesting all the way to this final round. Unintimidated at the moment. She's 61, he's 65, and it's Madison Payne on a hole shot by 1 inch, 2/10,000ths of a second. A young woman in her 20s has beaten one of the most iconic racing drivers in the history of American motorsports, Tony. I know he wanted it bad, but my goodness, could you script a more adventuresome beginning weekend for Tony Stewart?
Well, I think Tony said it himself. Everything after qualifying was just icing on the cake. One thing that I did notice, the way he was trying to stage the car in time as he acquires and accumulates experience, he will get smoother. He will be able to better focus on his starting line. He was actually pretty good. He continued to make progress. You can see the rear tires. And what a close race. And for Tony Stewart, this is not an ordinary man here.
Eric Anders had one simple job to do in Las Vegas, a job that she's completed 9 times coming into this race, and that's to win the event. She also wanted to lock up a world championship, but she needed a little help to do it. Well, once she got a little help, she didn't miss. Taking full advantage, this is how Erica Anders locked up a world championship for the 5th time in Pro Stock. They match each other to the thousandths. Koretsky's car, a small move in the lower gears, and at the finish line stripe, it is a 5-time world champion racer. 663.9, 206.67, adding to a 2014, 15, 19, and 20 title. She is a 2022 Pro Stock World Champion. She does not swing and miss.
No, this is every bit of a team effort, and the driver so many times has pulled wins out for the team. When she hasn't been able to do that, it's the car that wins races for the driver, and this team seems so reliable. And what most people don't see, we see the end result in the winner's circle, but a lot of the work, it's just like boxing. All the work takes place when nobody's there, when they're not on the big stage, in the shop, on the dyno, the investment, the sponsors. And this team, of course, they've done it better than anyone else this year.
Credit where it's due to Kyle Koretsky. Was not overcome by the moment, matched her, and that is the reaction of a 5-time world championship team on the starting line. The Elite Motorsports Group, Melling Performance, have done it again. She has now tied Greg Anderson with 5 titles. We'll be back right after this.
We'll be right back.
The road to the finals for the NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series is underway and headed to Southern California. Don't miss 300 miles per hour, 11,000 horsepower, and the dramatic conclusion to the NHRA season where world champions will be crowned. It's the Auto Club NHRA Finals, November 10th through 13th at historic Auto Club Raceway at Pomona. Kids 12 and under are free. Get tickets early and save at NHRA.com.
The NHRA Nevada Nationals is sponsored by Summit Racing Equipment, the World Speed Shop, and by Dodge. Domestic, not domesticated.
There's the tuner right there, Hector Senior. You know he is looking for a little performance, but sometimes you have to call on the rider, the driver, to get a little bit of performance off the starting line.
Angie Smith, his wife, looking on. We had some fun with them this weekend. Both riders are in. A 009 for Arana, 063 for Matt Smith. And for the second race in a row, you have got to be kidding me. 686.6 beats a 686.2. It is another of a hailstorm of hole shots we had over the course of this race day.
Well, if you want to double up anywhere, you want to double up
unreal.
In Las Vegas. Hector Arana did exactly what he needed to do. He got the jump off the starting line. A little insurance. He padded his chances. But when you look at the numbers, in 60 feet, they were identical. Hector Jr. was a little bit quicker at 300 feet, so it was all catch-up for Matt Smith, and it was the horsepower. They did both. The rider delivered as well as the tuner. They gave him a better machine than he has had all day.
He had gone seasons without a victory. He has not gone 2 weeks without a victory now.
Well, I would love to say, well, maybe he should take more off, but what this does, and I said this a couple of weeks ago, this is a great opportunity. You see a company, the support jumped in.
Yes.
I mean, this is a kid that gets on a bike. They are a great family. They're a great story, and they win races.
Of course, the first man to ever run 200 miles an hour on a pro stock motorcycle was one of the calling card signature moments in his career. And frankly, this now three race stretches, he will be competing in Pomona.
She pretty much mopped the floor with the competition. She forced them into making mistakes, and they obliged. They said, well, we'll go ahead and red light. But as far as the performance, nobody really had anything. The one car, the one driver that did was Greg Anderson.
Yes,
at times over the course of the season. But right now, I'm not going to say this is academic, because the driver right now, they're driving instinctually. When they get in this race car, they put the helmet on. That car is idling. They're going to roll the car into pre-stage and stage. They're going to rely on their instinct. And as competitors, they just want to win.
And for Troy Coughlin Jr., all of those things hold true. He wants to win this race just as bad as she does. His last win, of course, coming in Topeka, Kansas. His last final coming in Reading, Pennsylvania. They leave within a thou of each other. Absolutely unbelievable. They are glued together at the mid-track, and it's Erica Enders. Of course it is. 664-0, 206-86. Troy Coughlin, a 666-8. He was there with her on the starting line, but it is a wire-to-wire win for Erica Enders.
Well, right off the starting line, really within the first 60 feet. And what's amazing is these cars are tuned within the same camp, but the driver, the team, they are so familiar with one another. And it seems like whatever they do with Erica's car, it responds.
Let's go to the top end. Rather, Amanda Busick's with Hector Arana Jr.
Back-to-back wins for Hector Arana Jr. And you said that you were still in search of a ride for next season. How good is this for advertising that?
It doesn't get any better than this. Sponsors want to see winners, and we got a winner. But you know what? I can't thank Steve Bryson and GetTrex enough. They're the reason why we're here this weekend. And, man, Jim and Flo, thank you guys, and my dad. I'm losing my voice, but you know what? It was a scramble, because it's like all of a sudden we're coming to Vegas, scrambled, motorhome issues. I got to thank Josh at the truck shop, Lucas Oil Truck Shop, for, you know, making it possible to even get here to Las Vegas. So thank you guys. My wife, Nicole, Sophia, Ella, Daddy's a winner again. And I got to say thanks to my boss, Scott. He keeps breaking my balls about not mentioning him. So there's your mention. Thank you.
Well, Scott, there you have it. Our points in Pro Stock Motorcycle, you'll notice one name is not on this list, and that's Hector Arana Jr. He just keeps slaying it week after week, but now Matt Smith carries 104 points with him as a lead over Joey Gladstone to Pomona. And thanks to NHRA and Fox's Jen Lorenz for this fun fact. The number 15 qualifier in Pro Stock Motorcycle has only won twice in the class history of 487 races. And Hector Arana Jr. just did it today. Now we go to Amanda Busick. We're never going to get tired of talking to Eric Anders. She's down there with her right now.
Well, as she told us in the championship interview, the fire is not going anytime soon. And you said that heading into this season, you wanted to cross off another victory for yourself, and that was beating your season career total of wins. You now have that with 10. Erica, what is the ceiling for you?
Sky's the limit. With the good Lord's grace and blessing, we'll just keep on going. But I'm sure people are tired of hearing me talk as much as I'm trying to come up with unique information, but what a great day. We did what we call a hat trick. We got the number one qualifier hat, we got the winner's hat, and we got the white one, which means world champions. To be able to do it five times and join the list with people like Bob Glidden and Jed Coughlin couldn't mean anything more to me. But the men that stand behind me are the reason this happens, and I got a hell of a teammate in TJ Coughlin. He's a great driver, and we're just happy to park this Melling Performance Chevy Camaro in the winner's circle. I got David from High Performance Lubricants here, Mellon, Gallagher, Peebles, all the people that make this possible, C-Tech, CHE, they're all here, and we're going to SEMA this week. So for all my guys that give the glory to God, Dad, Mom, Court, we did it. Woo!
We'll be back right after this. The NHRA Nevada Nationals is sponsored by Camping World, making RVing fun and easy since 1966. And by Summit Racing Equipment, the world's speed shop. They ran a 92 to come in here. Hight ran an 87. Let's talk a little bit more about Matt Hagan with Bruno Massel.
Got a chance to catch up with Dickie Venables heading into this, and I asked him about that disparity they have in terms of performance. He told me they had some clutch stops in play that helped get down the racetrack. When the clutch stops are off, the tune-up they went 86 is in, and they picked away at it. They're going for an 84. They're looking to light up the scoreboard. They said they have nothing to lose and everything to gain.
And the clutch stops are just a tuning tool. When they let those clutch levers go, it accelerates. It makes the car more aggressive. It clamps the clutch sooner, more aggressively. That's one of the things, one of the ways they get these cars to move quicker, accelerate quicker in the middle.
They're off the blocks. Robert Hight smokes the tires, and the Dodge Power Brokers Charger is back in the mix. A 389.6 at 330 miles an hour as Hight's car. He desperately tried to pedal it early. 615.7 at 111. And boy, oh boy, you take the big guy who lives a big life and you bring him to a big town, and he makes a big time run in the final.
Well, you know, we love to see all the flashy numbers, but you can see Matt Hagan knows that he won. It was Robert Hight really losing the race early. Both of them extremely good, exceptionally good off the starting line, like they have been. Ron Capps rising to the occasion. Now it's Matt Hagan going up against Robert Hight and getting off the starting line. But problems set in early for Robert Hight. You can see the car leave, but the conditions have cooled off. The track has improved. The level of a grip has improved. But when the cool air comes in, these engines make more horsepower.
The header flames going on off like a light switch for Hight. Let's go to talk to Tony Stewart.
Tony, it has been a busy weekend to say the least, right? We got a chance to go out here and do this yourself. You just got time to change out of your fire suit. Disappointment or in celebration of victory, which is it for you?
Well, I'm going to go with the last thing that happened, which is victory. So, Dickie and Matt, they've done an awesome job all weekend. They are pushing hard, trying to catch Robert. And Robert and Proc, they're an awesome combination. They're very, very tough. So proud of this team, proud of this organization. And it has been an awesome weekend by far. So no disappointments here.
Congratulations.
Thanks, man.
If Brittany can pull this off, this is going to give her that little bit of cushion that they wanted.
Bruno has more on Brittany.
No surprise to talking to David Grubnick moments ago. He was disappointed in the 371 they ran in the semifinals. This is a guy who plans to live in the 60s. He told me the power level is down a little bit. This track is so good, it's soaking up the power. They need more power and more clutch application to get this thing to run where it's at. And he said he's put a bunch of both in.
If there is more power and more clutch application to be found, David Grubnick will find it. Top Fuel final in Vegas. She just snapped the 34 reaction time off on him, and at the stripe, it's Brittany Force on a hole shot. Why not? 3705 beats a 3702. This race, Tony, has been unbelievable.
What Brittany Force will do, she's not going to give you that kind of reaction time every time, but we've seen it several times this year that she has risen to the occasion. Now, this is under the lights, the big stage, the big spotlight, all the pressure on Brittany Force, the importance of coming out of this race with a win, and she does it on a hole shot.
It is race win number 16 in her 35th career final, and it's the single most important one she has ever pulled off. Amanda Busick is with Matt Hagan. I'm going to duck and cover.
Matt Hagan laughing just said, this old dog can still hunt. How hungry were you today?
So hungry. I was digging deep all day long on the starting line, and my guys were putting a good car underneath me, but we're just making good power again with this power broker car. And I tell you, it's just fun. It's super fun to get it crawled in this hot rod and get strapped down and, I mean, turning on wind lights. So that's what Vegas is about. We had a little lucky first round, so Vegas luck paid off, but this power broker car is running strong. Don't count us out. We're still working hard.
If there are reports of that Welcome to Las Vegas sign being bench pressed tonight at the end of the strip, I will give you the prime suspect. Let's look at the funny car point standings. And there's Matt Hagan, 41 and 43 back. This doesn't get any better.
Well, a points and a half. Now, qualifying is going to be very interesting because they are going to attempt and want to out-qualify Robert Hight to continue to close the gap. As it stands, it is going to be a three-dog race.
And Brittany, it was a 34 reaction time on a hole shot. What statement is that as we head to the last race of the season?
I'm making up right now for slacking all day long. These guys on this team, there is no easy job, whether you're the crew chief, whether you're the co-crew chief, clutch guy, bottom end guy, driver. It is tough. And we freaking got it done today. We made up a lot of ground, and we're chasing down that number one spot for this Flavor Pack Monster Energy team. And I'm telling you, woo! Vegas, I am pumped!
That champagne's waiting for you.
We now look at the top fuel points. The champagne's going to be flowing here in a moment. Two women grabbing their spots in the Sunoco winner's circle as Matt Hagan and Hector Arana Jr. join them. A 7-point lead for Brittany Force into the final race. Mike Salinas is 66 back. Antron Brown 78 back. And Steve Torrance, as unthreatening as this sounds, is still there. 87 points back behind the leader with points and a half coming at the Auto Club Finals. It's Vegas, baby. Let's spray some champagne. We got Brittany, we got Matt. We, of course, have Erica and Hector. Thanks for watching this NHRA in 30 Top 5 from the 2022 NHRA Nevada Nationals. I'm Brian Loans, and the final race of the season, the Auto Club Finals, are coming up soon in Pomona, California. Visit NHRA.com to get your tickets today and come see how one of the topsiest, turviest, wildest NHRA Camping World Drag Racing Series seasons ever will come to a close. Thanks for watching.